Hello and welcome, my good friends, Sepp Waldhandwerk, Susanne Williams again, our new German Bavarian film star.
Bah.
I put the link below. She was in the state television with a nice reportage about her. Yeah, if you like, and you should watch it. While we are here now, our friend Tinderkip from the US sent us some wonderful new great items. Tinderkip goes flint and steel. You will see, this is Tinderkip flint and steel at its finest. Awesome work, my friend. Wonderful what you have done. We have shown you videos before from like Tinderkip started with a Tinderkip, a wooden box case with a ferro rod in it, please. And a striker and each kind of tinder material you like to collect. Find tinder, put it inside here, stays on place and makes awesome sparks. The wind goes in the wrong direction, otherwise I could set Susanne on fire.
I think you just did.
I did, okay. Yeah, so, and because, and this is what I like so much on Tinderkip, how should I say it, he really believes in the bushcraft stuff. He's not just someone who says, bushcrafter, they are customers, sell them something. He really is complete into the stuff. And so he started with flint and steel. He tested many types of steel. I think this is O1 tool steel, and which make from his searching the best sparks. You can get it customized with name and whatever company on it. Tinderkip flint and steel. Yeah, and where to start? With the Charcloth. We have Charcloth here. Here's a nice tin, two holes in it, with charred material, and what I think is very smart with this keep things dry stuff, you know, from electronic and so on, really smart thought, why not inside your Charcloth tin? And he found out, and I found out, but I had no solution. You know, if you put the clothing on the fire, it often opens because it gets a little volume, get warm. And so he makes this wire spring stuff.
Yeah.
And now you can close it and sit it on the flames or on the coal.
Yeah exactly.
So, Charcloth tin with charred material. And if you like.
Yeah, it's the detail. So looking at just this little striker here, has actually got a little dint in it, so you can use it as a bearing block even for doing a bow drill. Very fine, tiny screws on it. The engraving on the name, and then these just beautiful, tiny little chips, and charred material in here, and then another little box in here to keep your all your little flint chips in.
And the ladder to keep it, to make that make no sound.
Exactly.
To walk through the woods and
look at this. Yeah. Tiny little box with a sliding top with another dry maker and char material in here. It's just incredible.
And you get awesome sparks from this. And first I was surprised about those sometimes really tiny flakes, but then I found out it makes totally sense because you have many more edges, and because of the good steel you do not need a big stone.
I think this
box has an extra ferro rod inside.
Yes.
If cold, wet conditions, or if you have problems with charred materials or no charred materials, you have also an extra ferro rod, normal ferro rod, inside this box.
Yeah. And then this thing. Amazing.
Ah, everywhere. Here is also
extra
ferro rod, flint chips, this cool striker with the bearing block use. And charred material in an extra tin. What I really like, look here, is chunk wood.
Ah.
Charred chunk wood is inside here.
That's incredible.
You can use these tins, of course, to char your material, but it's so wonderful made. Yeah, it's close to...
It's for the showcase.
Showcase, yeah, it's so beautiful. Yeah, but it's really made to use in the outdoors. So here is a smaller striker. Hört man mit in? Achso, da geht's nicht weiter. Ah, doch, here.
Wow.
They have magnets in it, so be careful if you have a pacemaker.
Or a compass.
Since I know Susanne, I need a pacemaker. Yeah, but I did not get one, so be careful. Don't put it close to your chest. Yeah, but so you can replace this on your maybe customized nice handle here. And what surprises me nearly the most is this small kit. I could put it around my neck with the tiniest piece of iron steel I ever had.
Ein bisschen,
ich hab's hier.
Ja, was du angezündet hast. So, der kommt hier.
Also make this stuff a little fluffy on the edge. Make your spark.
Oh, yeah. There it is.
And, yeah. Give this in your Tinder bundle. Super.
There it is.
Here
wow,
is
awesome.
Hot, This is a coal extender. This is hemp.
Wow. Awesome. The world's definitely the world's smallest flint steel kit, without question.
Wo haben wir dieses Lederstück noch bitte reinpackt?
Ja.
Und also gut with the leather. You can pull the stuff out. If you have no tin, I often use a piece of leather. I ignite a piece of cloth, let it burn. Lay it down and with a piece of leather I put it out and you end up with really good charred material. Nice,
yeah.
This hemp material is awesome, gell?
Yeah, it wants to stay lit. That's great.
Yeah, tiniest flint and steel kit I have seen so far.
I like it. I'm just thrilled about this, what a thought, to keep it shut. I mean, simple thing, right?
Yeah, super smart
ideas. Indeed. So I'm just loving this incredible detail of this thing. little screws, the machining. Yeah. Yeah, so little tiny pieces. We don't have a lot of these where we live, so these are treasures to us. On this little incredible engraving. I really like it. Lots of leather.
Should surpass.
Go. Lots of lovely chips. This
I love these tiny tins cases.
Yeah. Brilliant. You can never have enough little tins of things.
Absolute, yeah. The extra ferro rod.
And here's some
junk wood in it.
Exactly. Nice. I actually really like knocking my sparks into a
pile of charred material.
Yeah.
This is a buckskin.
Wow.
He also makes this wonderful, nice bags.
Yeah, just incredible skill and a lot of dedication to detail, like just in the sewing.
Look, the tiniest kit has the size of the kit from the. Just from the
material.
Charcloth material, yeah. And here's a complete kit in it, no?
Wow. Yeah, just the same as in the kit you have now. This tiny little stuff here.
Everything fits so well in it.
Incredible. Let's see if we can do a little close-up, maybe. Let's see if I can get it. Yeah.
Yeah. Good sparks, Susanne. Awesome. Let's look at it. Yeah. She made spark with it. Susanne, get not tired to tell me size matters. But here you see, if the small piece is sharp and you have the right skills.
Fingerspitzengefühl.
You can also make things hot and fire. So, what's now?
Coffee. I think we have to drink some coffee.
Yeah, and then she drinks espresso, the small one.
I didn't. I brought the ordinary kind.
Das hatte ich schon lange in Vorbereitung. Ich das Ding zum ersten Mal gesehen, aber ich wusste, da muss irgendwas auf die Größe sein bei dir.
Ja, Feinmotorik, oder? Awesome. Alright, also jetzt muss ich gucken, dass die richtigen Sachen wieder in die richtige Stelle kommen, weil das ist das Einzige, dass es nur auf eine Art beieinander passt und der ist sowas von specific. So ist es. It's a shame to put these things away, huh? I think they're so wonderful.
Yeah.
Yeah. So nice in
yes,
the hands, it's wonderful. Yeah, a pleasure.
You really want to play with it. You want to make fire all the time.
It's true.
Yeah. So, Tinderkeep, links below. Many thanks to our friend in the US for sending us these great items. And I hope you help him to build up his business.
Yeah.
Because he has really awesome and special ideas for us.
Yeah, do yourself a favor actually. It's just a pleasure to work with these things. When you get it in your hand, you're just, this is a great thing to work with. And it puts you in a good mood just to get the stuff in your hand.
Yeah, it's true.
So, awesome, buddy. I like it.
As we talked before.
Yeah.
Yeah, my friends. Many thanks for stopping by. This is it for today. See you soon in another one. All the best to all of you. Many thanks, Susanne Williams. Sepp Wollenberg. Für dich und geht's aus. Go on, das. Goodbye.